Hey guys!
And gals!
Today we will have a look at Tides for Mutable Instruments, the 2018 version of it, and I will try as much as I can to use modules that exist also in hardware. So if you have the hardware version of Tides, you can still follow along with the video. Now there's a lot to cover. Tides is really versatile and full of surprises, so there will be timestamp links in the description to all the different parts, and at the end of the video we will go through a patch that I built after the Loom 4 patch from Lightbath, which is all about Tides. As I said, Tides is very versatile, and we will start with using it as an envelope generator. We have three ramp modes we can choose from. We have an attack decay envelope, which is green. We have a cyclic mode in orange or yellow, and we have an attack release envelope in red. We will start with the AD envelope, the attack decay, so the green mode. I have here a manual gate module I will use just to trigger Tides. So let's send this to the trigger input of Tides, and as you can see, we have four outputs. The main output is output 1 all the way to the left, and the other three outputs will react differently according to the output mode we are in, and we will come back to the output modes later in the video. So let's send output 1 to the scope, and now if I trigger Tides, nothing will happen. You can see this right here, because the shift level knob in this case is acting as an attenuverter. So if I turn it all the way to the right and then I trigger Tides, we get an attack decay envelope. And pay attention to the fact that no matter how quickly I let go of the button or how long I hold it, we will still get the same result. You see, I click it really quickly, or I can hold it, and you can see it stays green and high. Still, I get the same result, nothing changes. So never mind if I do this quickly or I hold it. Another thing to keep in mind is the fact that the signal will only reach 8 volts, positive or negative, depending on the attenuversion. And this is the same also in the hardware version, so if you need more than this, you will have or need to amplify the signal. So you can see this also here on the scope, it reaches maximum of 8 volts. Now if we turn the level knob to the left, we will get the same envelope but inverted. It will start at 0 and go down to, again, around negative 8 volts. So again, in the center, we get nothing, and we can attenuvert the signal, so we don't need the whole 8 if we don't want to. We can attenuate and invert, so attenuvert the signal. Really nice. And here, down here, let me just go to it. I have here a small patch. I have marbles triggering Tides, and also sending pitch information to plats. And the first output of Tides, again, the main output, is controlling the level of plats. I also have some delay and reverb just for fun. So if I start raising the level knob of Tides, we will get some sound. And you can see the envelope also here on the scope. Now we can start looking at the other controls also. So first of all, we have the frequency knob, so we can control the rate of the envelope. And we can also sync the envelope with marbles by using the clock input. So we send the clock from marbles to the clock input of Tides. And now the rate of the envelope will be synced to marbles, and the frequency knob becomes a clock divider and multiplier. So again, it's synced to the clock of marbles. We can change the slope of the envelope, make it more percussive or more with a fade in. we can change the shape. And we can also change the smoothness and even fold this signal. Look at this. Or make it a bit smoother, just a bit. Now, what about the other outputs? Output 2 will output the envelope, the default envelope, but here we have less control, so we can only change the frequency and the slope, but we cannot change the shape, for example, not for this output, and not the smoothness also. So this those will have no effect on the second output. Output 3 is an end of attack output. Let's have a look at this here. We can also look at the original signal. So this is an end of attack output. So as long as the envelope, and you can see this, is in its attack stage, the signal will stay down. But other than this, it will stay up, it will stay high. And also here we have no shape control. This, the pink trace, is the first output that we have shape control, but not to the square wave or to the third output, and also no smoothness, but we can change how it reacts according to the slope of the first output. And then the last output is an end of release. And you can see how it reacts also with the original wave. Okay, now let's mute this for a second. We have 4 different modes, like I said before, the output modes that will change the behavior of the shift level knob and of the 4 outputs. We can change them by clicking this button here. And until now, we were in the default mode, and you can see that the light is off. And again, in this mode, the shift level knob acts as an attenuverter for the main output, output 1. So if we look just at it, again, I can attenuate and invert it. So this is in this mode when the light is off. But we have also the green mode, which is called different amplitudes. And now the shift knob will scan through the outputs and will send a signal through different outputs according to the position of the shift knob. So let's have a look at another small patch I have here. This one. I have 4 oscillators, braids, the even VCO, I have the black wavetable VCO from Erika Synth, and the cloud generator, the E340 from the E-series. Those are all going to Veils, again, Mutable Instruments. I have tides with the same settings, so in the same output mode, the green mode, and I have an LFO acting as our clock, triggering at tides through branches. So there is probability on the way to tides. And of course we have some reverb, again, just for fun. Now all 4 outputs are going to the CV inputs of Veils. And again, with the shift knob, I can scan through the outputs. So each time a different voice will get the envelope. So let's start scanning. You can see the lights here also. Now it's 1, 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 3 and 4, just 4 and then no output. So again, I can scan like this. Now in the center, it will not let any output out. If I turn it to the left, we can see this also on the scope. If I turn this to the left, we will get, again, a scanning through the outputs, but they will be inverted also. You can see this. So in this case, we will not hear anything because the level will go down, and we need it to go up in voltage and not down. So to the right, we will get some sound. Okay, now there's another mode, the orange mode. This is called different times. And as you can see, when the shift knob is at 12 o'clock, you can see it also on the scope. Let's take a different output, maybe the first and the third. When it's at 12 o'clock, we will get the same signal out of the four outputs. And by turning the shift knob, we will get a change in the slope for each of the outputs. And if I zoom in here, you can see it also. You can see we have different slopes. You can hear it also. And again, we can change the smoothness and the shape. Okay, now we have another mode, the red one. Let's change it. This is called different frequencies. And again, when the shift knob is at 12 o'clock, we will get the same signal out of the four outputs. But when turning the shift knob, each output will have a different frequency, so a different rate for the envelope. You can see one envelope is short, another envelope is a bit longer. Very nice. Okay, let's have a quick look at the AR attack release envelope mode. Okay, so the only difference between the attack decay envelope and the attack release envelope is that in this case, it matters how long the incoming trigger or gate is. So again, we are in the first output mode, so the light is off. I have here again plets, so we can listen to something. Now the level knob or the shift level knob is again an attenuverter for the main output, output 1. So let's turn it all the way to the right. And now the outcoming signal will change according to the length of the incoming trigger. So if I trigger this really quickly and let go, we will get a small, short, low envelope. But if I will hold this button, we will have an attack stage, then we will have a hold or sustain stage. And then when I let go of the button, it will release, so I can hold it as much as I want. And you can see we still have this hold or sustain stage. And now when I let go, it will release. Again, I can hold it shorter times or longer. So it depends on how long the incoming trigger or gate is. Now also here we can change the attack and release times with the frequency knob, so we can have a really short attack and release times or longer. Very nice. Again, we can change the slope, so we can make it something like this, like a ramp. We can change also the shape, so we can make this, for example, exponential. We can make this even longer. And again, as long as I hold this button, we will still have a signal. And then when I let go, it will release. We can also fold the signal, so change its smoothness. Very nice. And again, we have three other outputs that we can use. Output 2 will output the same envelope, but without the possibility to fold it, attenuvert it, or change its shape. So we can just change the frequency and the slope, but not the shape. and not the smoothness. It will not affect it. Output 3 is again end of a tech output, so let's have all three signals, and now you can see attack. It finishes the attack stage and then the gate goes high, or the signal goes high. And then we have end of release, so only when the release stage has ended, only then the signal will go up. Now attack, hold, release, and when it will end the release stage, the signal will go up. Now, one more time. Now. Very nice. Okay, so here we have the other modes, other output modes also. So let's have a look at another patch I have here ready for us. Very nice. So here I have marbles, again, mutable instruments, generating random gates with random lengths, as you can see it here. I just took the spread all the way up. So we have random gates and also with different lengths, which means that also the attack release envelope we will get will have different hold or sustain durations. And just like with the attack decay envelope mode, also here the green mode, we are in the green mode, green mode will scan through the outputs, through the four outputs. So I have here the even VCO, again Befaco, sending a few different waveforms to veils. And I also have kinks generating random pitch information through an attenuator and a quantizer. And now we can scan between the outputs and bring in the different waveforms, just like with the attack decay mode. Just here there is an importance to the length of the incoming trigger or gate. We can see the envelopes here. Of course, we can change also the parameters. Slope, the shape. We can fold this. I have it also synced to marbles through the clock, so we can multiply this clock. Okay, very nice. We have also the yellow output mode, this one. And again, this will allow us to set different slopes to each output with the shift knob. Have a look at the scope also. You can really see this, the difference between them. And we also have the red mode, which will allow us to select or set different frequencies for each output with the shift knob. So each output will have a different frequency. Okay, so you can see that the attack release mode was quite similar to the attack decay mode. But now let's have a look at using tides as an LFO in cyclic mode. Okay, so here we have another ramp mode, the yellow one or orange one, which is the cyclic mode. So tides will oscillate and will create bipolar oscillations. And just like in the other ramp modes, also here we have four outputs and four output modes. And we will start with the first one, so the light here is off. And also here, the first output is the main one, the main output, and the level knob also here will act as an attenuverter for this output. So let's open it all the way to the right, and already you can see that we have a signal, we have an oscillation, we have an LFO, a low frequency oscillator or oscillation. We can change its slope, so we can make it a bit more snappy. Something like this. We can change the smoothness, so we can also fold this and it will look something like this, which is nice. We can change the shape, so we can get all sorts of different LFO shapes, which is quite cool. and also the frequency, of course, the LFO frequency. And here we have three different modes. Here up, we have the yellow one, which is a range of 2 Hz. We have the red one, which is already audio rate, and we'll come back to this later. And we have the 1/8 of a hertz, which can go really low, and we get really slow LFOs. But let's go back to the two hertz range. We have the second output, from which we will get the default LFO. So again, just like in the envelope modes, also here we cannot change the smoothness for this output or the shape, just the frequency and the slope, which is cool. We can also not attenuate, vert it, the second output. From the third output, we will get a gate, and this one is, pay attention, this one is unipolar. And we can change the pulse width with the slope knob. We can change the pulse width of the gate. And from the fourth or the last output, we will get triggers. So very short pulses, so short we can hardly see them on the scope. And we can use this for all sorts of things. And again, we have the four different output modes. So let's go down here. I have a nice patch. Very nice. I have here plats in vowel synthesis mode, sorry, and tides is modulating. We have the four outputs, is modulating the timbre, modulating the morph, modulating the harmony. And I have here the harmonic, sorry. And we have here also a reverb, and it's modulating also the size of the reverb. And again, we are in the green mode. The green output mode, which will again, just like in the envelope modes, will allow us to scan through the outputs. So let's unmute this. Oh yeah. And now we can start scan through the outputs and modulate all the different things here. And of course we can change also the different parameters. So again, we can scan through the outputs. Now we have another mode, the yellow one. I have here another patch ready. Let's just make it like this. So again, we have the yellow mode. Here I have marbles, again, sending pitch information to two different, even VCOs. They are sending 4 waves to veils, and I have tides again in yellow mode, yellow output mode, modulating with the 4 outputs the levels or the CV of veils. If we unmute this, it will sound like this. Now you can hear maybe that the sequence and tides are not really together, not really in sync. So we can use again the clock input and sync the LFOs, which is amazing, with the clock. So you have synced LFOs, which is really nice. Now the frequency knob again becomes a clock divider or multiplier. Now in this output mode, the yellow one, we can change the phase of each output with the shift knob. And of course we can change also the parameters. Pay attention here on the scope. So we have, oh yeah, 4 different phases of the same LFO, which is synced. We can change the slope. Oh, very nice. So again, we have the same LFOs, but just with different phases. Now we have also the red mode. And in this case, again, just like with the envelope mode or modes, we can change the frequency ratio between the outputs. And in this case, because it's an LFO, we get nice polyrhythms. Oh yeah. so you can hear the polyrhythmic structure of it all. And again, it's synced with the clock, which is amazing. Okay, very nice. Now let's have a look at using this ramp mode, this cyclic mode, but at audio rate. So here I have tides again in the yellow ramp mode, so the cyclic mode. And let's change the frequency range to be C3, the red mode. And now the oscillations will be at much higher rate. And also here we have four output modes. And now again, we are in the first one, the default one. The light is off. And again, also here with the level knob, we can attenuvert the signal of the main output. Output 1, and already we will start hearing the oscillator, the oscillations. We can change the frequency, the pitch. We can change the slope and have a sort of a low-pass filter type of effect. We have now a sawtooth wave or ramp. We can change the smoothness and even fold the signal. And we can also change the shape of the oscillator, of the oscillations. Okay, now also here, the second output. From the second output, we will get the default signal. Again, we cannot change the smoothness for this one. We cannot attenuvert it. We cannot change the shape. We can only change the frequency and the slope. From the third output, we will get a pulse wave with the pulse width control via the slope knob. And from the last output, we will get a very narrow pulse wave. You have to keep in mind, let me just mute this for a second. You have to keep in mind that both pulse waves, so output 3 and 4, are unipolar, unlike the first two outputs, which are bipolar. Now let's have a look at the different output modes. So here I have a patch ready for us to look at. Very nice. I have here marbles sending pitch information to tides. Tides has a volt per octave input. Again, tides also is in oscillator mode, or in the oscillator audio rate range, the red mode. It's set to the green output mode. And just like before, with the shift knob, we can scan between the outputs and send the signals to different places. So here, for example, I have two outputs going to a delay and two more outputs going to a reverb. Let's have a listen to this. I will start scanning through the outputs. That's the delay outputs. Reverb. I can scan between them and send them to four different destinations. Very nice. Let's have a look now at the yellow mode. So I have here another patch, the yellow output mode. Here I have tides going through veils to a reverb. And again, in this output mode, the yellow one or orange one, we can change the phase of the outputs with the shift knob, and which will in this case add nice movement and harmonics to the sound. So let's have a listen to this. Have a look also on the scope here. Very nice. Now a really nice thing here is the red output mode. And here, once again, we change the frequency ratio between the outputs, which means the pitch ratio, because frequency is pitch. So we will get actually chords. So let's unmute this. And now when I take the shift knob to the right, you will get major chords. Let's take the frequency note up. And to the left, you will get minor chords. Oh, yeah. And somewhere around the middle, we will get a nice detuning. So you can sequence this, of course, through all the different CV inputs. Okay, very nice. Now let's have a look at the patch I've built, which is built after the Loom 4 patch from Lightbath. Okay, so there will be a link in the description to this patch and also to the video from Lightbath where he explains a bit about this patch. We have here two new tides and also one tides from the older version. We have veils, we have blinds, we have clouds for some delay and reverb. And in the video, Lightbath is using the KeyStep, so we will be using 12 key from Impromptu. And he also uses a clock from Yarns, another Mutable Instruments module, but we will be using a clock from JW. And Lightbath has also picks for a bass drum and a hi-hat, but picks is not available in VCV, so I will be using plats for this, one plats for the bass drum, one plats for the hi-hat. And the main idea behind this patch is having one tides. The first one is an oscillator at audio rate, and it's generating a chord in the red output mode. This is going to four inputs of veils. And another tides is used as an envelope generator, so it generates four different envelopes going to blinds, and from there modulating veils, so the levels of the voice. And as you can see, two channels on blinds are inverted, so there is a bit of variation between them. And also the second tides, the one that generates the envelopes, is set to the red output mode, so we get those polyrhythms. And let's really see how this sounds like. So this will be the first voice. Then we have the second one. You can change, of course, the slope. Let's bring the third one. And the fourth. Oh yeah. Just the first and the fourth. Very nice. Now the older version of tides is clocking the envelope tides. You can see this here from the unipolar output. And also it's also modulating the third channel on blinds. And it's also triggering the drums. So here we have the bass drum. Now a Lightbath, there is a part where the bass drum doesn't play on each trigger. It doesn't really know why it happens. I could not replicate this. So I'm using branches here, just so the bass drum is not playing on each of the triggers. It sounds like this. Sometimes it will be triggered, sometimes not. And it's also triggering the hi-hat. We can transpose everything with the keys. Okay, this is the basic patch, and of course it can go in many different directions. Again, link in the description, download this patch, have fun with it, explore it, and that was it. Explore also Tides, it's a marvelous module. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. If you enjoy what I do, consider becoming a Patreon. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the bell. And have a good one.